Hi students, welcome to SFS Kambam online classes. This is your Vijay Kumar sir, teaching social studies 8th class. My dear children, all of you follow our YouTube channel. Channel name is Vijay sir YouTube channel. Just subscribe and like so that you can get notifications of our lessons every day. So kindly follow our lessons so that it is very helpful for you to write the examinations and also get the good marks. Okay, without wasting our time, let's get started. Thank you. Today's concept is different places have different temperatures. My dear children, in the introduction class, we have learned many things about temperatures. So temperature varies from one place to another place. So you have seen already many examples in the introduction class. So different places have different temperatures. Why these different temperatures are happening? There are many reasons. Now we will take a look at some of the possible reasons. My dear children, places that are near the sea and far away from the sea usually have different temperatures. The places which are very close to the sea have different temperatures. The places which are far away from the sea have different temperatures. So here temperatures differ on the top of a mountain and its foot. So this was already we have seen in the last class, that is the mountains are not receiving uniform temperatures from the top to bottom because the sun rays falls on one side and other side the sun rays are not receiving. Okay, and also here if you go upside, that means if you go up, so the elevation, if you go up the temperatures may go down. Okay, every 1000 meters increase in elevation, so the temperature falls down by 6 degrees Celsius. And also here you already know that the temperature changes as we go north or south from the equator. In this picture you can see, my dear, equator line is there in the middle. If you go towards north direction from the equator, you will get less temperatures, you may go down less temperatures, right? If you go south direction from the equator, also may have less temperatures. So here places near and far away from the sea have different temperatures. We have already seen the average temperatures of Hyderabad. In the last class we have already discussed the average temperatures of Hyderabad. Hyderabad is far away from the sea. So there is no any big oceans and seas are nearby the Hyderabad. So it is far away from the sea. Now let's look at the temperatures of city that lies next to the sea, that is Panaji in Goa. So this is one location in Panaji, Goa. So this Panaji is the capital city of Goa. What is the capital city of Goa? Panaji. So this Panaji is located very close to the sea, that is Arabian Sea. So here they have given in your textbook average monthly temperatures of Panaji. Okay, if you observe this maximum and minimum temperatures throughout the year, so here constant temperatures, almost constant temperatures are there. If you observe January to December, 32 32 32 33 33 30, like that it is going. Minimum temperatures started from 19 degrees onwards. Whereas if you observe Hyderabad, temperatures varies from one month to another month. January temperatures are less, again February slowly increasing, March onwards increasing very heavily, and April, May huge temperatures are there, and June onwards slowly it is going down. And whereas if you observe November, December, again less temperatures are coming. So that means here, my dear children, Hyderabad is not close to the sea, it is far away from the sea. That is what it is having different temperatures. And whereas Panaji having It is very close to the or next to the sea. That is what it is having. It is maintained constant temperatures, right? So here the difference, if you observe, is Panaji minimum temperature is 19 degrees, maximum temperature is 33 degrees. So the difference is 14 degrees. If you observe Hyderabad, minimum temperature is 15 degrees, whereas maximum temperature is 39 degrees. Okay, if you observe, the difference is 24 degrees. Understood, my dear? So here Panaji having difference 14 degrees, whereas Hyderabad is having 24 degrees. That means 10 degrees extra. So like this way, the temperatures differs the places near the sea and far away from the sea, and recording different temperatures. So here the average of maximum and minimum monthly temperatures are plotted on the graph 2. You can also observe, this is Panaji average monthly temperatures, right? If you observe, they have drawn this graph based on the tabular information, tabular temperatures. Okay, so maximum and minimum temperatures, if you observe, almost constantly it is going on, right? Much more difference is not there from the January to December. No, much more difference, almost maintain constant temperatures, right? So here compare the temperatures of Hyderabad and Panaji. Just now we compared, right? So January is having less temperatures, and February, March onwards slowly temperatures are increasing, and whereas April, May month he receiving hot temperatures. Again June onwards going down, and when you observe November, December, almost very less temperatures are forming. But whereas in Panaji, it is having almost right from the January to December is having uniform temperatures. There is no any much more difference is we cannot find out in the Panaji, because it is it lies the place or city which lies very next to the sea level, the sea. That is what, so we are getting the moderate temperatures. Now and our next concept is moderate and extreme climates. Moderate and extreme climates. So here, my dear children, why does the temperature in Panaji not change much throughout the year? Why this Panaji is not having much more differences in temperature, and it is not having much more change throughout the year? Why it is happening? Because it is on the seashore. If you observe in our Indian map, Goa is located, because Panaji is the capital city of Goa. What is the capital city of Goa? Panaji. Okay, so Panaji and Goa is located very next to the Arabian Sea. That is called seashore. Okay, so it's difficult for the sun to heat up or cool down the surface of the sea. As you know, the nature of water, that is the water gets cool or water gets heat very slowly. We have discussed in the introduction part, water is getting heat or cool very slowly. So here, since the sea does not get too hot or cold, the air above the sea also does not get too hot or cold. Okay, so when the water gets heated, slowly the atmosphere also gets heated. When the water gets cool, immediately slowly the atmosphere also gets cooled. So therefore, places near the sea usually have temperatures that remain fairly constant throughout the year. So that point you have to remember, my dear. The places near the sea usually have temperatures that remain fairly constant throughout the year. So this type of climate is called as moderate climate. You understood, my dear? The meaning of moderate climate is maintaining medium and constant temperatures throughout the year. Understood? So the places which are near to the sea usually have temperatures that remain fairly constant throughout the year. This type of climate is called as moderate climate. In contrast to this, Hyderabad is far away from the sea. So there is no moderate influence of the sea in Hyderabad. So in summer season, if you observe, the ground temperature rises up and this heats up the air, because the Hyderabad city is not close to the sea, it is far away from the sea, and also it is not having moderate influence of the sea. So that is what, in summer, in winter, in rainy season, if you observe, it is having more different temperatures. In summer also, so the ground temperature rises up and this heats up the air. In winter season, ground temperatures falls down and the air is also cold. Okay, so this is called as extreme climate. What do you call this? Is called extreme climate. So that is, here extreme means one with the great difference between maximum and minimum temperature. So great differences will be there in maximum and minimum temperatures. Already I told you, if you observe the table of temperatures of Hyderabad, it is having 24 degrees differentiation is there, whereas Panaji only 14 degrees. That means compared to Panaji and Hyderabad, 10 degrees extra is there. Understood? So each month it is having different variations, because the city of Hyderabad is located far away from the sea. So that is what, it is having extreme climate, whereas Panaji is having moderate climate. So extreme climate means the places which are not having uniform temperatures and is having different temperatures, we can say that is extreme climate. Next concept is heightened temperature. At the peak of summer, some people go from the plains to hilly places such as Ooty or Shimla to avoid the heat. My dear children, you can also observe, in summer season, most of the people, they want to go to hilly regions like Ooty or Shimla in order to avoid the heat, because in our location, in summer season, more hot temperatures will be there. Whereas if you go to Ooty or Shimla, okay, these are all hilly places and they have naturally very cool temperatures will be there in summer. So that is what, in order to avoid hot temperatures, they may travel to hilly regions like Ooty and Shimla. Even in summer months, the temperatures are low on hilly regions. Understood, my dear? So in summer regions also, they may have less temperatures in hilly regions, because the highest parts of mountain generally have the lowest temperatures. So already we have discussed in the last concept, when you go up, okay, when you go up, the temperatures may go down. It is having less temperatures. Okay, temperature decreases with elevation. Elevation means height. If you go height in the up, so naturally the temperatures decreases. Okay, look at the graph showing. Okay, look at the graph showing the average monthly temperature of Delhi and Shimla. You can see quite clearly that in each month of the year, the temperature of Shimla is far lower than that of Delhi. You can see in Delhi, the average temperatures, okay, so like this way. So here, the average temperatures, maximum temperatures started 21 degrees onwards, whereas minimum temperatures, it is, okay, between 5 to 10. So if you observe Shimla temperature, see once, the minimum temperature is almost 1 degree or 2 degree. Maximum temperature, if you observe in the January month, that is 6 or 7 degrees. Okay. So here, if you observe month wise in Delhi and whereas Shimla is having more difference. Understood? Because Delhi is at an elevation of about 200 meters above sea level. So Delhi is located 200 meters above the sea level, whereas Shimla is at an elevation of about 2200 meters above the sea level. Okay, so the difference is 2000 meters. So Shimla is located above 2200 meters from the sea level, whereas Delhi located 200 meters from the sea level. So compared to Delhi and Shimla, what is the difference here? 2000 meters difference here. Okay, so that is what usually for every 1000 meters increase in elevation. That means if you go up every 1000 meters, the temperature falls by about 6 degrees. Just now I told you, if you go up 1000 meters, the temperature falls down about 6 degrees. Understood, my dear? So due to this cool temperatures, different kinds of plants grow on high hills and mountains. So due to this, because Shimla is receiving more cool temperatures and whereas Delhi is receiving hot temperatures, because the elevation part, if you observe, Shimla located 2200 meters above from the sea level, whereas Delhi located 200 meters above sea level. So between Delhi and Shimla, how much difference? 2000 meters difference is there. That is what Shimla is receiving 12 degrees less, okay, than the Delhi, because each 1000 meters up, 6 degrees falls down. No, that means 2000 difference is there. 2000 means 6 plus 6, 12 degrees difference will come. So if you observe Delhi, 21 degrees are there, but whereas Shimla, if you observe, that is 6 or 7 degrees. Okay, so that means almost 12 to 13 degrees difference will be there, right? So likewise, due to this cool temperatures, different kinds of plants grow on the high hills and mountains. Okay, because of this cool temperature only, the many plants grown on the high hills and mountains. My dear children, today we discussed different places have different temperatures. The places near and far away from the sea have different temperature. Okay, moderate and extreme climates we discussed, and next one, height and temperatures we discussed, right? So all of you read this important concepts, okay, and also you have to make full bits and questionnaires also. Understand the concept, my dear children. Watch the video 1 to 10 times, okay, there is no any problem. If you watch 2 to 3 times, there is no problem. Okay, it is freely we are providing, no? So you watch 1 to 10 times, okay, then catch the points how I am telling you, with examples I am giving you, okay, how the temperatures are receiving Delhi more than the Shimla, because the elevation difference is there. Shimla located 2200 meters above from the sea level, whereas Delhi located 200 meters above from the sea level. Okay, so this type of variations you have to observe, and the temperatures, how it is happening differently, happening from one place to another place. Okay, these are all very, very important concepts for your upcoming classes also. So all of you catch the points, listen carefully and underline the important points, make your own bits, and also questionnaires also you frame and write. Okay, and next concept we are going to learn, inversion and temperatures in places near and far away from the equator. Okay, so temperature maps, likewise 3 or 4 concepts are there. We will finish in the next class. Afterwards I am going to conduct another 2 tests about this chapter 2. Okay, get ready for that. Don't wait for up to examination time. You have to prepare by yourself before only. Okay, don't wait for me to conduct the exam. Somebody asking when you are going to conduct, sir. Are you ready? Shall I conduct now? So that is what you prepare yourself. First you thoroughly you prepare yourself, finish your class works and whatever you have project works we given. So that also you finish. Project work also, another project work I will give you. So that also you finish. How many of you finished your project works? Only SK Ayesha I received recently. She showed through WhatsApp it's very good. So likewise, remaining students also prepare. Okay, so I don't want to blame you, just I'm giving you some indication. So all of you prepare and trying to get good marks. Okay, so next class be ready. Until then, take care and bye bye.